Hello students, here we are going to learn about Media Access Control Protocol, MAC protocol. So the Media Access Protocol, MAC protocol layer exists just above the physical layer in the OSI model or Open System Interconnection model. So it is designed to ensure orderly and the fair access to a shared medium. So it manages the division of access capacity among the different stations on the network. So a good MAC protocol should be the following criteria. First is efficient. There should be high data throughput and the packet should not experience large transfer delay. Second, fair. Each station should have equal access to the medium. And third one, simple. The implementation of the MAC protocol or Media Access Control Protocol should not be so complex that it is required powerful hardware or long processing times that impair performance. This conflicting requires have been challenges a MAC protocol designer ever since the development of the Palo Alto protocols. The need for speed and simplicity. So in this case, MAC layer outweighed the benefit of the efficiency. So the MAC problem scheduling transmission in broadcast and select network can be posed a matrix cleaning problem in which traffic matrix must be processed time slot by time slot until all entries in the matrix are clear. So the current trend in design of MAC protocols for WDM means wavelength division multiplexing LAN local area network to employ a centralized architecture rather than the distributed architecture. Central control that allocates bandwidth. Requests are sent by user to the central controller and that allocates the bandwidth to according to a given scheduling algorithm in the MAC protocol. The use of such scheduler allows control over the bandwidth allocated to the different services and hence the provision of QoS quality of service requirements. Many different MAC protocols have been proposed a scheme ranging from random access scheme, fixed access scheme, time divisible multiple access to reservation scheme where node reserve communication subchannels also. So next we'll define the MAC for the most important topology. So first MAC protocols for star topology. So the MAC protocol for the star topology describe according to some criteria. So first criteria is tell and go. So what is a tell and go? So a MAC protocol that supports the features allow a station to inform the destination, that is the transmitting a packet, and then transmit the packet without waiting for any form of acknowledgement. So that's why tell and just go. Second, channels. So the number of channels according to in case of optical networks, a wavelength. So the number of channels or the number of wavelength required by protocol including the control channel. So the next, equipment, the component that are required at each station in the network is known equipment. And the last, throughput, the normalized throughput S. So normally this throughput is defined by the S. So equation of S is lambda x bar and sigma. So this is equation of throughput in the MAC protocol for the star topology. So where lambda is the number of new packet generated by the by per second. So new packet generated by per second. X is the average number of bits per packet. And this lambda is known as a transmission capacity of the network. So this will define the throughput for star topology. So it is desirable for the MAC protocol to have low processing requirement at each node. So next, MAC protocol for bus topology. So the first criteria is FairNet. So the FairNet medium access control protocol addresses their unfairness by using a probabilistic access mechanism. So that aims to provide a equal share of bandwidth to all the node. Suppose bandwidth is there, then how many node is occupied that bandwidth, then equally distributed this bandwidth among the all node. Second one is WDMA. So the wavelength division multiple access protocol. So this developed for the extension of single channel distribution QL dual bus DQDB, distributed Q dual bus network, to the multi channel case. And these are the W wavelength on each of the two buses with channel lambda zero used for the control purpose. So two buses is there, two direction distributed in case of WDMA. So basis on the DQDB, next point is NDQDB. So the NDQDB protocol is also generalized for the DQDB protocol to the multicast case. It differs from WMA in that pre-allocates the transmission between sender and the receiver and therefore does not require a control channel. So that's why NDQDB is better from WDM or DQDB bus. MAC protocol for ring topology. So in the ring topology, all the nodes are in the circular medium. So the first point is token passing. So in case of token passing, under the multi-channel token passing protocol, so each node is equipped with fixed transmission and fixed receiver. So W fixed transmitter and fixed receiver. So what is a W? So W is the number of channels. How many number of channel is occupied? So token allowing transmission are passed around the ring in the round robin order. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Second, request allocation protocol. So request allocation protocol is a collision free protocol. Time is divided into uniform slots. So each slot is divided into two sections, header and second section is data. So the header section contains n mini slots. Header section contains n mini slots where n is a number of node in the network. And the second section is a data section. So header requires n mini nodes and the second section is known as a data section, is divided into m data mini slots. So DMS, data mini slots. So in order to transmit data, a node first requests DMS, data mini slot, and then wait for an allocation. So this is for the request and allocation protocol. So third one is a synchronized round robin. So in this case SRR. So synchronized round robin is a collision free protocol for the ring network only, where each node is equipped with tunable transmitter and the fixed receiver. And the last one, reservation ACK acknowledgement transmission protocol. So this protocol is designed for using the ring network where each node is equipped with the wavelength ADM, WADM. So the full form of WADM means wavelength add drop multiplexer. So a WDDM is a device that selectively adds or drops or passes through optical signal according to the wavelength. So basis on that reservation acknowledgement or transmission protocol.